世界的尽头。灾难的巅峰，战场上的勇士，耶稣快再来，你预备好了吗？预备迎接末世。
A special welcome to all Angel TV viewers who are watching this program.
我们欢迎所有收看安吉 TV 的观众朋友们。
This program is called Prepare to Meet the End Times.
这个节目叫做预备迎接末世。
Its purpose is to make us aware and to prepare for the future.
目的是让我们对未来要发生的事情有一个警觉的心和预备的心。
The topic of discussion has been marriage for men.
我们所讨论的课题是男士们的婚姻课题。
In the previous sessions, we have been looking at how to have financial freedom.
我们在前几集所讨论的课题是如何拥有财务上的自由。
We will continue with this thought and look at step number 15, which is choosing a good name rather than great riches.
我们要继续讨论这个课题，我们谈到第十五个步骤，就是寻求好名声胜于大财富。
Broken promises, secret sins, cheating the wives, dishonoring parents, and returning evil for good are violations which cause God to withhold funds.
不守约定。隐藏的罪，欺骗配偶，不尊重父母，以恶待善，忘恩负义，这些都促使神收回他的祝福。
Let's turn to the book of Malachi, chapter 3, verse 10.
让我们翻开马拉基书第三章第十节。
Bring all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be food in my house.And try me now in this, says the Lord of hosts, if I will not open for you the windows of heaven and pour out for you such blessing that there will not be room enough to receive it.
万军之耶和华说，你们要将当纳的十分之一全然送入仓库，使我家有粮，以此试试我，是否为你们敞开天上的窗户。请服于你们，甚至无处可容。
Men, I want to encourage you to seek what is good.
各位男士们，我要鼓励你们寻求美好的事物。
Do not get involved in things of the world, but protect your household.
不要参与在俗世的事情上面，但是要保护你的家人。
Be loyal husbands to your wife.
作为一个忠实的丈夫。
For God has given you your wives.
因为神把你的妻子赏赐给你。
Now let's move on to step number 16, knowing how to receive funds through prayer.
让我们进入第十六个步骤，就是借着祷告领受神在财务上的祝福。
God delights in having His children trust Him for their daily needs.
神喜悦他的儿女们在每日的需要上面寻求他的供应。
When riches increase, however, it is easy to stop depending upon the Lord. And when we feel that we do not need the Lord, we lose our love for Him.
财务上面的加增会导致我们不依靠神来寻求他。当财富增加的时候，我们就会觉得我们不再需要神了，我们也失去了对他的爱。
To remedy the situation, God brings unexpected needs, which force us to His word and prayer.
为了挽回这样的情况，神很可能会带来意料之外的缺乏，以至于我们被迫要借着 他的话语和祷告去寻求他。
Ephesians chapter 3 verse 20 and I read, Now to him who is able to do exceedingly abundant above all that we ask or think according to the power that works in us.
神能照着运行在我们心里的大力充充足足地成就一切超过我们所求所想的。
Man, get into the habit of putting every need that you have to God in prayer.
男士们要养成这样的习惯，把你一切的需要都借着祷告带到神的面前。
And as God makes you rich, keep yourself in a humble state so that you will not lose your riches.
当你寻求神在财务上面赐福给你的时候，你要继续保持一个谦卑的态度，好让神可以继续不断的来供应于你。
Keep thanking and loving God for everything that you have.
在你一切的事情上面都要寻求他，而且爱你的神。
I have come to a point when even I'm having a shower, I thank God for the water because He created the water.
就我自己个人来说，甚至当我在洗澡的时候，我都为着我能够有水来洗澡向神献上感谢，因为这是他所供应的。
The best way to receive from God is to thank God that you have received them.
最好的感恩就是为着你所能够领受的或将要领受的向神献上感谢。
Step number 17, having the courage to avoid partnerships.
第十七个步骤就是要能够勇敢地拒绝伙伴关系。
A man must purpose ahead of time to reject any financial gain which comes as a result of violating scriptural principles.
一个男人必须预先有这样的一种考虑，要能够去拒绝那些违反圣经原则的赚钱方式或者违反圣经的原则的财富。
The basis of secular humanism is the thinking that the end justifies the means.
世俗的人文主义的想法就是能够自圆其说，把一切所得着的都归属于自己的功劳跟能力。
Daniel purposed in his heart that he would do what was right regardless of the cost.
但以理在心中定义，他无论要付上什么样的代价，他都要在神的面前做一个正直公义的人。
When you get involved in a business partnership, you get involved in that man's life.
当你跟另外一个人合伙做生意的时候，你们这种伙伴关系其实也就让你参与在他的生活当中。
If the partner you got involved with does not know God, how can that business prosper?
如果你的商业伙伴他是一个不认识神的人，那么你们的生意要如何能够得着神的祝福呢？
It is best that you don't have a partner. In this way,As you do the things that are right before God, you will prosper.
那还不如没有任何的生意伙伴，好让神可以按照你的对他的信靠而大大的来赐福给你。
Step number 18, detecting and conquering slothfulness.
第十八个步骤就是要能够察觉及克服懒惰。
Trying to live without working is rebellion against God's order.
一个不想工作而想能够继续享受生活，那是对于神的秩序的一种反叛。
Many men don't like to work, but they just want to receive all the blessings from God.
有许多的男人，他们不想工作，只想享受神的祝福。
God has determined that provision must come by the sweat of the brow.
神已经定义 它的供应必须是来自于劳力，亲手劳力所得的。
In 2 Thessalonians chapter 3 verse 10 it says, For even when we were with you, we commanded you this, If anyone will not work, neither shall he eat.
我们在你们那里的时候曾吩咐你们说，若有人不肯做工，就不可吃饭。
There is no such thing as easy money. We all have to work for what we want to earn.
没有所谓容易得来的财富，我们都需要付上代价，努力的工作，才能够赚取钱财。
Now let's move on to step number 19, listening to the cautions of your wife.
让我们继续到第十九步骤，要愿意听从你妻子的警告。
Many financial disasters can be avoided by listening to your wife's caution about a financial decision before it is made.
很多财务的危机是可以避免的，如果一个男人愿意听从他妻子的出于谨慎的一些劝勉、一些提醒的话，那么就可以避开这些财务的危机。
God has designed the wife to be a helpmeet for the husband.
神设定妻子作为男人的帮手。
As such, she has special abilities to sense danger which are often overlooked by her husband.
如此，神就赋予她一种特别的能力，就能够在危机出现的时候能够为她的丈夫提出警讯，通常是做丈夫的所忽略的。
Let's turn to Proverbs chapter 1 verse 5.
让我们翻开箴言书第一章第五节。
A wise man will hear and increase learning, and a man of understanding will attain wise counsel.
使智慧人听见增长学问，使聪明人得着智谋。
Even if your wife does not understand the business that you're doing, you still need to ask her for counsel.
尽管你的妻子也许对你的商业的行为跟这个投资一窍不通，你仍然需要能够去聆听她所提出来的一些见解跟警讯。
Especially if your business is about to enter into a new project.
特别是当你的生意要进入到另外一个计划的时候。
Our intimacy with the Lord is very important, but our intimacy with our wife is also important.
我们与神的亲密关系是非常重要的，我们与妻子的亲密关系也是同样重要的。
When there is unity between husband and wife, God declares a blessing.
当丈夫和妻子有合一的关系的时候，神就会赐下祝福。
Now let us turn to the last step, number 20, knowing how to pass on an inheritance which ensures a godly and responsible heritage.
让我们进入到第二十个步骤，就是要知道如何将遗产传给下一代，建立一个敬虔负责任的传承。
An inheritance is God's way of passing on a heritage to the children and grandchildren.
遗产是神将财物传承给儿孙的一种方式。
God's primary purpose through the inheritance is to strengthen the larger family unit.
神的主要目的就是要借着遗产的传承来建立一个更坚固的家庭单位。
Vital functions such as the education of the children, the health care, home provision, care for the elderly, and resources for business are some of the responsibilities which God intended for the family to meet.
一些重要的功能，比如说孩子的教育问题、 健康的支出，还有家庭里面的开销，对老年人的照顾，还有生意上面的资源，这些都是神希望借着家庭的聚集能够建立的一种责任。
There are also dangers in an inheritance. Thus, God gives both a challenge and a warning.
遗产也会带来一些危险性，因此呢，神就给了一个既是挑战，又是一个警告。
Proverbs 13, verse 22. Let us read this verse.
让我们翻开箴言书十三章二十二节。
A good man leaves an inheritance to his children's children, but the wealth of the sinner is stored up for the righteous.
善人给子孙遗留产业，罪人为义人积存资财。
Proverbs 20 verse 21, and it says, An inheritance gained hastily at the beginning will not be blessed at the end.
箴言书二十章二十一节，起初速得的产业，终究却不为福。
I want to encourage all the men with regards to inheritance.
关于产业的遗留，我要鼓励所有做男人的。
If you can provide an inheritance for your family members while you're still alive,
当你还活着的时候，如果你能够把你的产业遗留给你的家人的话，
It is a good thing.
这是一件好事。
Most of the time, the world teaches differently.
大部分的时间，这个世界所做的教导是相反的。
It is only through the death of the provider that the children inherit the money.
只有在那位供应的人离开这世界的时候，孩子才继承这些财产。
But with the things of God, when you are able to release the money or the inheritance to your children, you can guide them.
但是如果你按照神的吩咐和神的指示，把你的财产要遗传给你的孩子跟儿孙的时候，你能够教导他们关于对神敬虔敬畏的事。
You can guide them by giving them wisely or godly counsel.
你可以指导他们，让他们能够学习敬畏神，能够按照神的旨意去行。
And you will be blessed when you see your children taking hold of what you have given them.
当你看到你的儿孙能够按照你的教诲，他们去遵行的时候，这将会带来一个极大的祝福。
You will have a sense of fulfillment that you have done what God has required you to do.
你会感觉到一种满足感，因为你按照神的指示，按照神的旨意去行。
So I want to encourage all the men, enjoy your family as you see them grow, but what you have provided.
所以我要鼓励所有做男士的，在你的家庭里面能够有这些美好的传承，好让你看到孩子们都在按照敬畏神的方式来成长。
Now let us look at the role of the husband.
接下来让我们看到做丈夫的角色。
The New Testament suggests that there are six main responsibilities of the husband.
圣经在新约教导我们做丈夫的有六个主要的责任。
The first one is love your wife.
第一个就是要爱你的妻子。
This is a command clearly stated in the book of Ephesians chapter 5.Verse 25.
这是在以弗所书第五章二十五节很清楚的指示。
Husbands, love your wife, just as Christ also loved the church and gave himself for her.
你们做丈夫的要爱你们的妻子，正如基督爱教会，为教会舍己。
If the men do not love their wives, they are disobedient through Scripture.
如果做丈夫的不爱自己的妻子，那么他们就是违背圣经的教导。
This is a self-giving love, and it is the husband who should take the initiative in giving himself to and for his wife.
这是一种舍己的爱，就是做丈夫的要主动的将自己给予他的妻子。
Genuine love is released by an act of the will, and we should not think of love as purely emotional.
真正的爱是出于意志上的决定，是意志的一种行动。我们不要以为爱只是一种情感上面的冲动或者感觉。
Let us turn to the book of Psalms, chapter 18, verse 1.
让我们翻开诗篇第十八篇第一节。
A psalm of David, the servant of the Lord, who spoke to the Lord the words of this song on the day that the Lord delivered him from the hands of all his enemies and from the hand of Saul, and he said, I love you, O Lord, my strength.
诗篇第十八篇第一节，耶和华的仆人大卫的诗，交与灵长。当耶和华救他脱离一切仇敌和扫罗之手的日子，他向耶和华念这诗的话，说：“耶和华，我的力量啊，我爱你。”
David made a decision to love, and his love for the Lord was released by an act of his will.
大卫做了一个决定，就是要爱神，而且他对神的爱是借着他的意志所带出来的行动来爱神。
However, the word David uses here for love is more than just his will, and it involves his inner emotions.
然而在这一节经文里面，我们看到大卫他的对神的爱是超越了他的意志，甚至连他的情感也都对神表现出他的爱。
Men, the success in marriage does not depend on how it was entered into, but on how a couple conduct themselves after they are married.
做男士的，我们要知道，婚姻的成功不在乎你们怎么样子的开始，而在乎这对夫妻如何的在他们的婚姻生活当中彼此互相的对待。
Both need to be faithful to their responsibilities.
彼此都要忠于他们所当负的责任。
We have come to an end of this session. And once again, I want to release a prayer before I go.
我们来到了本节目的尾声，再一次的，我要为大家做一个祷告。
Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ,
天父，我们奉主耶稣基督的名，
I bring before you all the married men who are listening to this program.
我要将所有收看本节目的已婚的男士带到你的面前来。
Help them to understand the role they have as a husband.
帮助他们了解，明白他们作为丈夫的责任。
Help them to release genuine love to their spouse.
帮助他们能够对他们的配偶有真诚的爱。
And protect them from all the temptations of this world.
也能够保护他们的配偶脱离这世界所有的诱惑。
So that they can excel and be blessed.
好让他们可以能够更美好的生活，而且能够得着祝福。
In Jesus' name I pray, Amen.
我奉耶稣的名祷告， Amen.
We look forward to seeing you again in the next session. God bless you all, Amen.
我们期待下周同样的时间能够跟你们再见面。奉耶稣基督的名祝福你们， Amen.